Users are becoming smarter. They know exactly what they want. They are searching for the solution. They don't just go to the integrator and ask, please have, I want to have a control system. They are checking by themselves. They understand what the market can offer. They are coming with requirements, very detailed requirements, and they are looking for someone to address each one of their requirements. And they want to have things very, very simple, to keep things simple. They understand that if things will not be simple, this will drag the IT managers to support, a lot of support, because the user that enters to the room, they don't like to handle technology. They just want to come and present. And if you're giving them the right tools to present and to avoid all the technology and understanding the technology, it makes their life easier and you will not get a support call. And this is what they're trying to avoid, the support call. So if you are giving a user interface which is very, very simple, addressing an, you can say, uneducated user, it's not really an uneducated, it's a user that did not pass any training on the system, and the user can use it immediately without any training. The touch panels, the traditional big, complicated and very expensive touch panels are being replaced slowly with our smartphones or tablet or very simple touch panels. And the reason is that you want to be able to control it from any device. And you want to get the feeling of simplicity. If today you give a smartphone to a 2-year-old kid, he will just start to use it. You don't want to get a printed user manual with print screens which you need to start and learn. You just want to plug and play. That's it. And the control has to go to this direction as well. We need to think of a room as a plug and play. Do as many things as you can automatic. Try to have a predefined scenarios. So most of the things will happen automatically. You enter to the room, there is a sensor, the room wakes up. The lights are on, you are connecting the cable. Automatically the display or the projector goes on, the lights are dimming. So you have several scenarios, and you can give the user also the touch panel so he can either take over, so he can decide to change the scenario, but he needs to do it very simple. If you will give him a very complicated scenarios, he will need your help. And if you have 200 rooms in an organization, you don't want to get phone calls to the IT managers every time a meeting starts. And then you will have more and more software-based. This will make updates very easy to be done over the network. You will not need anymore to do a firmware upgrade. You will not need anymore the installer to come and update the hardware or do an ECO or an RMA or all the things that are related with hardware. And of course it will be cheaper because hardware costs money. Software is development, of course you have to cover it, but still the prices of software-based solutions are much cheaper than hardware-based solutions. And this is where we are going to have more rooms that can use control, because if it's getting cheaper, more people adapt it. They will have to adjust. They will have to think about which services they can offer with the software. Is it updates? Are the updates are free or they charge for it? Is it warranty? For example, if you have bug fixes on it or anything, you are going to give it first year for free, second year for free, maybe you will have a program for it. Any updates to the room, we know that people likes to keep being updated. The cost of the hardware went so down, so today you can buy a 4K display for 3,000, 4,000 euros easily, and it's a 50, 60 inch. So people would like to be updated. Technology is changing all the time, every year we have something new. And as long as you can give this service from remote, if someone is changing this display with another, you can do the change from remote, you can charge for it. So I believe that the support, the fact that support can be done from remote, you can price it. The fact that software has always updates. If you look at hardware, once you get it, you get it. It's either working or it's not, but it's a one or zero. With software, it's an endless. The same software can get more and more and more features, and you can charge for it. AV and IT are slowly merging. The IT market is much bigger than the AV market. So more likely that the AV will migrate into the IT world and not vice versa. For an IT manager, I think it will be much easier to learn AV than for an AV guy to learn the IT world. And as things go to the internet, goes online, today you have less fixed metric switchers, for example, and more AV over IP. And this is totally IT field. It's AV, but it's on the IT field. So there will be a shift. And I think that's a green field. So companies who will find their way in the IT world, they will gain much more business and market share and faster than companies that will insist of sitting on the AV side only. And I think the control is the bridge, because control is controlling the AV, but it's part of the IT market. It's on the network. It's software based. It's totally an IT solution.